Earlier this year, there was a giant iceberg that was heading towards South Georgia Island and became a very big potential threat to the island and the biological life on it. Most people would be surprised to find that in the middle of Utah, I track icebergs in Antarctica.
Why is BYU in the middle of the desert involved in tracking icebergs? Because we do remote sensing. It's BYU students that do the actual tracking of the icebergs. They create a database of these icebergs that we provide to scientists to use them for a variety of research and navigation purposes.
So this is A68 right here, and it calfed.
The big threat with A68A was that the trajectory it was following was headed right for South Georgia Island.
Now this is a pretty large iceberg, over 100 miles long.
And A68A was bigger than South Georgia Island. And if it was on a straight collision course, it could destroy the underwater ecosystem there.
As the iceberg moves in too close, it will block access to their feeding area. Then the animals have to go around the iceberg to get to their feeding grounds. And that'll add hundreds of miles to their foraging trips, which could lead to a colony collapse.
Icebergs this big carry so much energy that when they crash into a landmass or they get stuck on the ocean floor, that's a really big deal. So we kept a pretty close watch on it, updating its location daily and as much as we could. We have some of the best resolution resources available, so we were able to monitor where it was going and how it was responding to the ocean currents.
Those blue lines show the tracks of the icebergs from our database.
And we finally saw that it was going to veer off, and it eventually started to break apart before it made contact with South Georgia Island. So we had 13 breakoffs, which is a lot of berg babies, as I call them. And it became quite a handful to keep track of all these little pieces. And so that was a very exciting and interesting time.
We have one of the largest iceberg tracking databases of Antarctica, and the BYU students have been contributing to this by developing the processing techniques to make these images and to analyze them.
I go into work and I sit down on my desk and I'm looking at Antarctica. That's what I do for a couple hours every day. And my coworkers next to me are working on Greenland. We're contributing to a greater good. And that's a big part of what we do here at BYU, is we're involved in caring and monitoring how we affect the Earth and how that's affecting all of us.